prices starting to creep higher. The near-zero inflation era may be ending. Prices are rising slightly, and economists expect a steady climb as the recovery gains steam. In recent earnings reports, some retailers and manufacturers have said they're boosting prices this year on clothing, groceries, and other items after holding firm in 2010. The uptick is largely driven by surging food, energy, cotton, and other global commodity prices as economic growth heats up significantly in China and emerging markets. U.S. firms largely absorbed higher costs last year in the belief that price increases would drive away penny-pinching consumers in a weak recovery. But they can withstand shrunken profit margins only so long. You run out of margin and eventually close, says investment strategist Bruce McCain of Key Private Bank. Also, consumers are less wary. The government said this week that consumer spending rose at a healthy 4.4% annual rate in the fourth quarter. The consumer price index in December rose 1.5% from a year ago, the most since May. Yet wholesale prices for finished goods jumped 4%, indicating firms were squeezed. Federal Reserve Chairman Ben Bernanke dismissed inflation worries on Thursday. Let's see what Mark Faber had to say about Bernanke dismissing inflation worries and the BLS reporting U.S. year-over-year price inflation of only 1.5%.
Are you concerned about rampant inflation? And I use the word rampant because we're dealing with high levels of inflation many places and dealing relatively well for the time being with it. I mean, in Russia now, 6 to 7%?
I'm not sure about that because I have a very large subscription base and I ask my readers, whoever thinks that his cost of living is going up by less than 5% per annum, to please send me an email. I didn't get a single email. And I guarantee you also for your family and for every family in the US, the annual cost of living increases are more than 5% today. And the Bureau of Labor Statistics is continuously lying about the inflation rate, including Mr. Bernanke. He's a liar. He's a liar. Inflation is much higher than what they publish.
Bond market flashes inflation warning. The U.S. bond market has begun sending a message that inflation risks are rising and the Federal Reserve may be too slow to act, potentially marking a significant turning point in the economic recovery. In the past week, Treasury bond yields have jumped to their highest levels since last spring. Yields on 10-year Treasuries surpassed 3.5% and 30-year yields broke through 4.7%. Which makes some worry this could mean rates will march even higher. Long-term rates have been gradually moving higher in response to an improving economy and rising commodity prices. But in recent days, the increases in yields accelerated. A move many say is due to the worry that the Federal Reserve may be underestimating inflationary pressures in the economy and may act too slowly to tame them. Inflation is bad for bondholders, eroding the value of their fixed returns and sending the prices of their bonds lower. Canadian dollar drives to 2.5-year high on jobs data. The Canadian dollar hit its highest level against the US dollar since May of 2008 on Friday. While bond prices held lower after a US government report showed employment rose far less than expected in January. Stronger than expected Canadian job gains for January underpinned the Canadian dollar's climb to as high as 98 cents to the US dollar. At 9:27 a.m., the Canadian currency was at 98 cents to the US dollar, still firmer than Thursday's North American session close at 99 cents to the US dollar. U.S. employment rose by a meager 36,000 jobs in January, far less than the 145,000 increase the market had expected. But the employment rate fell to its lowest level since April 2009. Although it was reported that employers added 36,000 jobs for the month, if you take out the upward biases used by the BLS as part of the birth-death model, over 50,000 jobs were lost for the month. Yes, the unemployment rate fell to 9%, 300 jobs short of it being 9.1%, but that's only because the civilian participation rate, or the number of people in the labor force, is now down to a 26-year low of 64.2% from 64.3% in December, 64.5% in November, and 67.3% a decade ago, back in January of 2001. Total seasonally adjusted payrolls now stand at 130.3 million compared to 132.1 million a decade ago in January of 2001. The total civilian labor force is currently 153.2 million compared to 142 million a decade ago in January of 2001. This means there are 1.9 million less jobs than a decade ago, but 11.2 million more people looking for jobs.
Empty the till, put your bills right here, because I'm robbing you, sir.
You sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
Why do you want to do that?
Because I need the money. I've got kids that need to be fed, sir.
I know I am, sir.
I realize that. And I really am sorry to have to do this, but I've got kids.
How about if I give you $40 and this is it?
Well, I can't do that, sir. I've got rent to pay, I've got bills. And the kids need to eat. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. And I really am sorry. And if I ever get back on my feet again, sir, I'll bring it back.
I'm sorry. God be with you, man.
Thank you very much. And with you, too.
Thank you.